Hello, hello. Hello. Mississippi Mud, number one. Hi. How you doing? My ear's itching. What does it mean when your ear itches? Is that a sign? Spooky wife, Lolo D. Michelle Davis. Hola. What's everyone doing? Anything going on the YouTube streets today? Angela? It's dirty, you little smart ass. My ear is not dirty, I can tell you that. Green Eye, hello. Susie Q, hello. Millie, hello. Little Miss Sunshine, hi. Wanda, hello. Andy, hello. Panda, Vanna, Clover. Now y'all are going too fast for me now. Off, hello. Gigi, I'm too honest for this. Hello. Sarah Jane, half pint. D. Marie. Imspies, hello. Dina, Missy B, Amy, hi. C Star, hello. Frenchie Mom, Marlena, Robin, River, Karen, Roxy, Anne, Aurora, All Things McGee, Buckeye, Millie, Guidance, Roxy, Desi, Roxy. Cheeky, hello. Hello, hello, Ginger, Christina, Sarah, Jane, everyone. Hello. If I missed anybody, I don't mean to. Good to see you all. What's everyone doing? I am 500 hours away from my channel, this channel being monetized. So thank you all. I appreciate it. We should get it this live, as long as I stay live long enough. Should be able to apply for monetization. I see you. Hello. I have been cleaning all day. I have been cutting grass and doing the Sunday bit. I wasn't planning on going live today. Hey, Poppy. Beagle. Hello, Butterfly. Susan. Hello, Joyce. But I went ahead and came live for a little bit. I've been blowing your phone up all day. My bad. No, it's fine. My phone goes off constantly. You know, it goes off so much I don't even pay attention, to be quite honest with you. It goes off so much. I don't even hear it, to be honest with you. I just don't. It's weird. Let me check my phone. Hold on, Josh just text me. Anything going on the YouTube streets today? We miss you like you miss us. That's right. That's right. Anything going on? I know that JLR, there was some supposedly credible tip. Does anyone know anything about that? Nothing. I think it's like the first pretty day in a lot of the states, you know, because it was like raining for a lot of us for a few days, and today it's nice, and you know, it was snowing day before yesterday, and outside it's 70 degrees right now, so it's just the way it is. Yes, it's on his channel. Is he going to that area? Speak for yourself. It's freezing here. Oh, you're in Boston. You're in Boston, Amy. It's always freezing in Boston. Well, not always, but it's really nice during the summer in Boston. But summer doesn't start in Boston till June. You know what I mean? It'll get better. It'll get better. Yes, it was someone thought they saw Sebastian on the morning at 5:30. So they think they saw Sebastian 2 hours away at 5:30 in the morning. Probably was documenting a few places. I was tempted to glance at the Tennessee street cams. Yeah. Yeah, they're doing like a podcast or something together. They're doing a podcast or something like that. So that'll be good. Josh is producing it. I don't know. I think they're going to be on a lot of different platforms. Yes, it was a truck at a gas station. Did they think they saw Chris or Sebastian? Or both? That's what I would like to know. Because I don't know. I just don't think Sebastian in a truck. That would be amazing. Yeah. Did they report this to TBI? Does anyone know? I'm just trying to catch up for today. Yes, and the lady is still emailing with JLR. It was called in Sebastian in a dark colored truck. They said Sebastian in a 3-4 ton truck, navy or black truck, not the driver. They'll have to. I mean, did they take pictures or anything? Does anyone know? There's at least one fake Facebook under the name Seth Rogers with Sebastian's picture, but it's not Seth. So they did that during. I can't think of her name right now. Her last name was Soto, not Madeline Soto. It's Katrina. I can't even think right now. She was pregnant. Katrina, was it Katrina Soto? No, because Sebastian wasn't missing yet. Savannah, thank you. And they made like a bunch of fake profiles, and they were terrible. They would say horrible things, and Facebook would not take it down, like at all. Nothing. Wouldn't take it down. Like, she would, like, they would say things that is just the most taboo things that you could think of. They would not take it down. I mean, thousands of people probably reported it. Wouldn't take it down. I don't know. She's still up. She's still up. That person. Still up. Oh, hold on. I think Trev's going to go live tonight at some point. I just asked him earlier. He said, yeah, probably tonight. Someone made a fake profile of my mom after my brother passed away a few years ago, and Facebook won't take it down. We've been fighting. That's insane. Like, it's not them. Well, some of you may know, if you're familiar with the Summer Wells case, there's this woman, and she said that she's the one that, like, made up a bunch of lies about Summer, that Summer was at this one place and all of that, and she was kind of do things on Facebook and she does things on YouTube every once in a while. Well, she stole my picture. She stole one of my pictures and she posted it on her profile on Facebook and said, me, back when I used to take good care of myself. Like, I know I'm a girly boy, but you can tell I'm a boy, right? I hope. It's the goal. But I messaged her. I'm like, you remember that? I see you. Yeah, I was furious. And she's like, I was like, why do you have my picture? And saying it's you. And she's like, what are you talking about? She argued with me. She argued with me. And I'm like, am I the crazy one here? Because I'm arguing with this crazy. But she's like batshit crazy. She did something with she tried some stuff with Trevor, I think, the first year Summer went missing. Some crazy mother chickens out here, y'all. Speaking of pics, text me later if you remember. I have a question off topic. Maybe you might know. Okay, sure. Hey, Kathy. If you hear a cat meowing, I apologize. He's getting ready to get his little Oompa Loompas cut off the 10th, like Tuesday or Wednesday, something like that. Old Trevor got lost in the sauce. Oh, God, that's what Chris says. People are so weird. Someone posted my oldest son's picture when he was a young teenager saying he was her son and how proud she was of him. What the thud? Exactly, Mex Chica. It's like, what's wrong with these people? I don't know. Now, is last proof of life, Sebastian was at 6:30 p.m. on the 25th. Reported missing at 6:30 a.m. on the 26th. What were the Proudfoots doing for those 12 hours? You found it, Vet Girl. Yay! Yeah, that's the question. You know, I wonder if Chris... Okay, I'll ask y'all in a second. Do you know anything about Katie's mom's criminal record and accusations essay of Katie? So we do have her record. I haven't looked over it significantly. All I know is that there's a lot of criminals in her family. I think she doesn't want to be. Thank you, Vet Girl. I think she doesn't want to be associated with her family, to be quite honest with you. I think the Proudfoots are more like her family than her actual family. So I think that's what it is. Now, put a 1 in the chat if you think Chris was home the night it happened with whatever happened to Sebastian. Put a 2 in chat if you think he came later, later on in the evening. Put a 3 in chat if you don't think he came at all until the next day. And put a 4 in the chat if you don't know. So it's very mixed. Very mixed. Yeah. Very mixed. The mean review hate channels need to call out Facebook bullshit and leave some YouTubers alone. Oh, are they starting? My money is still on Mommy Dearest, and I'll die on that hill until proven otherwise. Angela, it is. Honestly, it's. To me, it's just as possible that she did it as he did. I really think, in my opinion, Chris, you know, it's hard for, I think it would be easier for a step parent to unalive your child than you unaliving your child, you know. So that's why I kind of, and with Chris's behavior, so that's why I kind of think Chris is number one, but she's not far back from it. But I just think Chris is so controlling and just very deceitful. And I absolutely, Chris would be bailed by now. Yeah. I mean, I think he likes kids. I don't think he likes, I mean, he might not like kids, but I think he probably doesn't like other people's kids. Right. But even if you don't like other people's kids, you don't hurt them. Right. You know, some people are not kid people, and that's absolutely fine, but you don't hurt them. Right. And don't marry someone that has a kid and make the entire family suffer, make the child suffer, and even make yourself suffer. There's no way he didn't do his house for the whole month. Yeah, there's no way. No way. Well, you go to, I think it's, what is it? What's her? Nancy Grace. And like he'll say in one breath, like he wasn't home all month. And then he'll say, well, I was there, but I can't tell you what weekends I was there. And she asked him again, and she's like, correct, meaning like you haven't been there all month. And he's like, correct. And he, in the same sentence previous to that, he just said he'd been there, but he can't say the days. It doesn't make any sense. Y'all, we know since Sebastian disappeared, so many back and forth trips from Memphis, when the whole month of what February supposedly stayed away. Yeah. Yeah. Why are they doing all of these now? And I don't know if there's something that's making them stay there. And I will put anything on that. That's one thing I absolutely believe. Now, what is it that is making them stay there? It's not a job. We know that because they came back and his job was up in the air. I don't even know if he's working now or not. I don't, probably not. But what is it? What is it that's making them stay there? They're more comfortable there. Why are they more comfortable 3.5 hours away than in their lovely, beautiful home where their son, where they say their son walked out of? I don't know. In my opinion, it's either they think or know, rather, in my opinion, that Sebastian is somewhere in the Hendersonville surrounding areas, or it's something to do with they are in Mississippi because they want to watch something, perhaps, or they know where he is in that area. So it can go either way. Possible the home is bugged. Oh, please. I bet you. I mean, we've got the Secret Service, the FBI, the TBI, and local law enforcement. Listen, they can X-ray you probably from 2 miles away, let alone, you know, hear you, I'm sure. So I would think that they're not even speaking about it. They're probably writing at this point, because you don't want, you know, you don't want them to hear. They don't want them to hear, rather. Yep, Blondie. It's beyond that they could leave, that they could take down flyers, allegedly, and how they can take down the flyers off of their car. You think he's trying to prove to CVS that he has been home so he can get his daughter back? I don't know. I think he doesn't want, I absolutely believe that he does not want his daughter around Sebastian because of the essay allegations. And he thinks, in my opinion, he thinks Sebastian, and Seth said this, could possibly do that to the others, which is such a horrible thing to, you know, a horrible thing for him to even think about. Everyone else says where they were, but one person, confusing. Well, I mean, he says that he was, you know, in Memphis, but he said he didn't even need a lie detector to test because, well, he was in Memphis. I think he will do it to his daughter. I mean, I don't know. Allegedly could. You know, a lot of people said that. I honestly don't think so. I really don't. Some people do think that. I think, I don't think Chris wanted anything, nothing to do with Sebastian. Did he work the crane on the weekends? I don't think he did. My opinion, Sebastian is close by where they are. I think he's close, Pamela, in my opinion, but I don't think he's super close. I don't think he's in the areas where they have already searched. He's probably outside of those areas. He might have been, but not on the job site on Sunday. That definitely speculated. My issue that makes me sad is how scared Sebastian must have been and is. Yes, that's the sad part. An accident during an argument, cover up. I think Chris is the type that snaps very quickly, flies off the handle. I think he's very similar to Don. He gets mad, peaks very quickly, becomes physical, and then after that, he goes straight down and will apologize. Or if not apologize, he'll calm down. I don't think he'll necessarily apologize, but I think he'll calm down. Sorry. Yeah, not on Sundays. You're not allowed to have. You're not allowed to. What is it? There's a noise ordinance. Justin, I think Sebastian is in that RV, or they did something to him and evidence that RV. So, Jules, I believe that the FBI was, and JLR has said this, so I'll say it. I knew it when JLR knew it, but I didn't say anything at this point. But allegedly, the FBI was there at the camper or the thing the other day, day before yesterday, I think it is. And they were looking at stuff in the motorhome. I think Chris is kind of person that doesn't take accountability for anything. Yeah. I think he likes to blame, though. Look back on the weeks. They could have been searching, but they feel threatened, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. Chris reminds me of my ex who left at the altar. Oh my God, Kimberly. I am so sorry. I mean, I know you're better off now, right? But damn. Like, why'd you have to drag me all the way to the altar for this, right? Sorry, guys, I'm yawning. I swear I stay like sleepy. Hold on, I'm trying to fill up my vape here. Yes, guys, if y'all don't mind hitting that like. Reality wins, it's your birthday. It's your birthday. I've got to sing to you like Marilyn Monroe in a minute. I have a theory, but many people have talked about it. Can I call in to discuss without a bunch of people jumping on me for it? Oh, I'm not doing call-ins right now, Andy, but I mean, you can put anything you want in the, you know, here. As long as it's respectful, no one's going to attack you. My mods will make sure of that. We accept all theories, I mean, opinions, everything. We love to hear. You sing Marilyn Monroe too. I want to do a Nancy Grace parody. I would love to do a Nancy Grace parody. Why no neighbors have signs? I don't know. What happened to Clutch Them Pearls? It's still there, baby. Still there. This is just my third channel. That's all. So when I hopefully I'll have my big channel back May 28th. I'm pretty sure it'll be back May 28th. Like I've been posting on it for some lives, but I'm still gaining followers, which is, I'm like, how's that? But thank the Lord. Did you notice in one of the first interviews Chris and Katie did when she was just rocking, she says something very aggressive. She states, they still haven't found my son, and then dead ass stares at the camera. Oh, really? Which interview that was? No, I haven't asked her. I haven't asked her yet. I think she'd be okay with it. I want to do bombshell. I love Nancy Grace. Chris reminds me of my ex. He was a mama's boy, short fuse, and never responsible for anything. Don't you love those? Why did MP say in a post that she was getting hate over a 15-year-old that goes missing in the middle of the night? No one said when he actually went missing. That's true. That's a good point. So Seth mentioned that investigators still have his Switch and electronics, and we know Sebastian loves Minecraft, and we know there are a lot of... Yes, Andy, that's true. Now, the problem that I personally have with that theory, this is just my opinion, is that, you know, you would think that, number one, the only time he really talked to anyone else, I believe, was when he was around Seth. He wouldn't have had access to anyone, I don't think, while he was in the Proudfoot home. But second of all, there's no evidence of him leaving at all, at least alive. There's no scent or anything. But no windows were open and they didn't say they were locked. Yeah, you can play Minecraft offline. Sure can. Hey, Emerald. Sebastian's community is searching and supporting him. Yes. Sebastian wasn't spotted by anyone's cameras. Yeah. If he left to meet someone, he was good to miss the cameras and the scent dogs. Yeah. I mean, you can't, you know, no matter how good you are, right? You know, especially being a kid and having the condition that he has, in my opinion, I mean, he just wouldn't be able to not detect a camera or the scent. And you know, you think they would be able to find him through like stoplights and all that, traffic lights. I would think it would be someone outside. The family expect for the behavior and the fact that they haven't looked at all. Yeah. There's no way someone isn't on video somewhere that night, morning, even if it's just KP car leaving when she goes to look for him. I mean, I think, you know, from Chris said she to Nina that Sebastian went missing anywhere from 12:30 to 6 a.m. The 12:30 was interesting. Why 12:30? Hold on 1 second, y'all. Sorry about that. I think I just broke my phone charger. But Justin still wondering why no scent outside. Even should be some scent with him going to the bus stop. Well, there wouldn't be I mean, he hadn't went to the bus stop in several days, so I don't think Sebastian's mom needs to rise up and protect her innocent son and bring him. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I want, like, it's not an excuse, and I don't want to ever think anyone's making an excuse for Katie, but I wonder if she's just given up. Hey, Grace. You know what I mean? If she's just like given up and she just looks like she's in just warped. I think she has, in my opinion, she has probably a really bad drinking problem. And she works at home a lot, you know, some days of the week, and I think of the evening she gets pretty lit. She went to the bed at midnight, but she never checked on him. Mm-hmm. Said no mom ever, right? I don't think KP really heard anything around 10 p.m. It could be a cover-up. Yeah. So what I think happened, I think whatever happened to Sebastian happened to him before 10 p.m. Absolutely. I think it happened to him before 10 p.m. because he would have been in bed by 10 p.m. Right, it was a school night, and there's no thing of him taking a bath or anything else, right? So in one interview of Katie, I think Smiley's Katie said Sebastian was not online playing games, like to watch people playing video games. How could he do that? That's a good point. Yeah, he liked to watch people play video games, like on, I guess, YouTube and stuff, because that's a big thing on YouTube. It's watching other people play video games. But how could he do that if he wasn't online of some sort? Exactly. With that internet, you can't do that. Chris could have kidnapped him and taken him away. Anything is possible at this point because of the sighting at 5 a.m. at the gas station I just commented about. He did not watch people play video games. He did not watch people play video games live. He watched videos of people playing the games. Yeah. Doesn't matter if it was live or not, you still got to have some type of internet. Whether it's live or it's not, you got to have something to for the data to come through. Does anyone know how many neighbor security cams would have been avoided for nothing to be seen? I don't know. I mean, Chris, if Chris wasn't supposed to be there, she could have drove Chris in during the weekends or whatever in her own car. Chris could have parked his truck anywhere in Hendersonville, perhaps, or even somewhere in the neighborhood or around the neighborhood. But I really wonder about her leaving that morning. They said she was gone for quite a bit of time. The parents could download the video from the device using parental controls. Yeah, they could, but I mean, shit, you would think he would let him choose the videos that he wants. And maybe she did, but that would be a lot of work. Like, do you want this? Do you want to watch this one? Do you want to watch this one? And then he watches it and he comes back. I mean, let the kid pick, put parental controls on so that he can't watch anything that's bad and let him watch what he wants. It's crazy. Someone runs out of their home without shoes, usually because of a fire. What was the firestorm occurring? There was definitely a storm of some sort. I wouldn't recognize him by the older pictures I saw of him today, said. He looks, I mean, with his photos on TBI, he doesn't, I mean, he looks younger there than some of the more recent photos of like Christmas. What else? Who else was trying to avoid the storm? Murdoch. Yes. Seth said the room was a mess. Sebastian's room from law enforcement going through it. By the time I think Chronicles of Olivia got there in the home, her reporter with her said room was spotless. They cleaned like crazy. Oh, I bet you that place is clean. Yes. When was the last time we saw so many law enforcement conferences on a runaway? Yeah, good point, Vet Girl. They don't do these press conferences on a runaway. No, they don't search landfills for someone that voluntarily ran away, or, they just don't. This will seem a far-fetched, but after listening to Seth talk about some of Sebastian's inappropriate behavior, could he have met someone in a bathroom of a bowling alley who suggested a meetup? You know, that's a point. That's a point. Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. They're responsible for regardless if physical. Yeah. In my opinion, his mattress was in the garbage can. I wonder about that mattress, Grace. Something is up. Something is up. Who embarrasses a teenager in high school and makes them wear? Can you believe that asshat? Ugh. Maybe back then. Can you believe he made? Do they have proof of bowling? I don't know. That mattress ties in somehow. I mean, the last thing I would have been worrying about after my son or my stepson was taken would be someone bringing a used mattress over. Why is it a used mattress? Because in my opinion, they didn't want it to look brand spanking new. Evidence had to get it out. I don't know. Now, we wasn't supposed to know that they searched the landfill. We was not supposed to know that. But it leaked. And we found out about it. Have they searched any other landfills? And it just not leaked? Maybe. They're concerned about everything but Sebastian, yes. Yep. There's no way that mattress could fit in that size of garbage can. It depends. It really depends. So, you know, if it's, which it probably is, in my opinion, it's like a foam mattress. Well, there's, you know, you can cut it up. And you can throw it. Hold on, 1 second. Give me 1 second, y'all. I need to get my mother-in-law something. Sorry, y'all. My mother-in-law was making some appetizers. Sorry about that. I just ran up 2 flights of steps. I'm out of shape. Been raining in Massachusetts for weeks. His scent not giving them a trail to lead is a huge statement. Yeah. Yeah. Tennessee has a long history of, they don't really name suspects, TBI. Thank you, that girl. Rivers, I would have taken my sweet. I think it's rude when, like, someone pauses for a long period of time. Quinny said, new mattress box was by the trash on Easter. Did you say earlier that FBI was, they were allegedly at the campground day before yesterday, looking around and taking stuff out? Justin, I thought that they had a court date coming up in March, is now postponed due to Sebastian being missing. Well, they've already had a court date since Sebastian's been missing. I think something happened to get rid of Sebastian before the next court date. Yeah, they had a court date, what was it, 2 weeks ago? Something like that. What if they put Faith's mattress on Sebastian's bed? Yep. I mean, I don't understand. They was already supposed to have, they had one in January as well. From what I understand, they was just taking out pretty much like everything. And like, I think they was like laying it outside and searching it that way. Well, I have Faith's bed in the garage when she has a room. Why have any bed in the garage when they all have, there's bedrooms in all of them? Right? I mean, all the bedrooms have beds. Who said Faith is coming to live with them? Never. Faith would never. That would be like hell for her. But it still begs the question, did Katie think that this is normal for a teen to wear a diaper? He's only got diagnosed a year ago. Yes. I sent you a text on that. Let me know about the two teenagers in my local. Okay, Fences. Thank you. Thank you. You know, every kid, every human being wants to fit in somewhere, right? Everyone wants to be loved. Everyone wants to be accepted by someone or some group. And that's the human condition. But the thing is, how was Sebastian supposed to feel normal or like his friends whenever even his friends may not know it, that he has a diaper on underneath, but he does. That's in his mind. So he can never, you know, be like them, because you don't feel like you're, you know, a normal kid when you're 15 years old and you're wearing a diaper because your dad, your stepdad, is a narcissist pig. Yeah, he didn't need diapers at Seth's. The only time he didn't wear diapers was when he was at Seth's during the weekends or holidays. Yes, it's Kelts, yep. Mm-hmm. Yep. It was absolutely for humiliation and control. That's exactly what it was. Yes. Sebastian's regression was trauma-based. If he were true progression, he would need to wear pull-ups at Seth's also. Absolutely. Yes. It's definitely from trauma. I mean, how does one get essayed so young? When they take you to the hospital and you get an R kit at so young, do you know what they do with an R kit? That is traumatic, especially after you've been through something so traumatic to begin with. It's sad. The children that were traumatized but didn't have a chance to develop, if that was occurring, why was he in high school? Yes, he had to hit milestones because Seth said the disability didn't place him. Yeah, he took normal classes. It was just he took, they just gave him a little bit more time. Then look at one. I'm about to send you a pic. Okay, Rhonda. Will it say your name? Oh, hold on. Cassie emailed me. Hi, as Smiley mentioned certain similarities of Summer's case and Sebastian's. This is a good video from the Vault YouTube channel. It was planned. Could Katie and Chris watch Summer's case on how? I wondered that myself. I'm like, did Chris and Katie ever watch The Wells? See how they can get by with it? Perhaps. Candace North works in Tennessee Development of. Who's that? Who's this? I can't believe there's 700 of y'all in here right now. Thank you all for being here. Who's this? Candace Nicole Loudon. Does anyone know? Big difference. Their education experience is actually a handicap. They knew better. I love y'all here too. I need a nap so bad. Oh, thank you, Don. Thank you, Joyce. That's okay, crazy bunch. Yes. Wrecking ball. Thank you, Priscilla. Yes, Team Seth. Team Sebastian. I'm sorry. I'm eating right now and I never eat. So I think it's really rude, but my mother-in-law just gave me food. So I'm trying to mute. Let's watch something. Let me see if, someone sent me this. I think it was this. I don't know who that is. Someone just sent me. Here's Nick Barris. Oh, this is for March 1st. Trying to see if he posted anything. Oh, here's the solar eclipse. Okay. Does anyone live in the solar, where the solar eclipse is going to take place? Anyone? The weather's supposed to be bad. What time is it supposed to happen? One PM Central. We can see it in Nashville, but not full coverage. It's like 90 to 95%. That's really good though, 90 to 95%. I live right here. Right here, like literally on this line. So I'm not going to get much, I don't think. Total solar eclipse playlist. Invisible sun, the police. Black hole sun. Soundgarden. Yeah, you could. I think there's like a. This is like. Some states are doing like a state of emergency because of like all the people traveling. Is it? Amy? Yes, get your glasses ready. You can make your own glasses too, I think, if you don't have them. Don't Let the Sun Go Down on Me, Elton John. Love that song. Total Eclipse of the Heart, Bonnie Tyler. Love that song. Blinded by the Light, Manfred Mann. Love that song. Dancing in the Dark, Bruce Springsteen. Love that song. Looking at the Sun, Matthew Sweet. Don't know if I know that one. Here Comes to Sun, The Beatles. Don't remember that one. The Sky Full of Stars, Coldplay. Know that one. Eclipse, Pink Floyd. Love it. That's interesting. This is like a big deal. I mean, some people are like, do you need earthquake insurance? The Tennessee Department of Commerce. East Tennessee Fault Line. Oh, that's interesting. There's three fault lines in Tennessee. New Madrid Fault Line, East Tennessee Fault Line. What's that?
Two of them. Holy cow. So you didn't even go down much further. This is it. Yeah, right here.
We did.
Oh, there's one there. That one's a big sucker. Two of them. Holy cow. So you didn't even go down much further than this.
This is it. Yeah, right here.
This is probably more down.
Yeah.
We got to look. Okay. Oh, you guys.
Can you see that one?
Look at that.
I don't know where you guys are, but in Tennessee and in like Virginia, Kentucky, West Virginia, North Carolina, there is. People love to mushroom hunt this time of year. They love it. You know, now Nick Barris, he looks more like the type that likes to like the other mushrooms, in my opinion. I'm going to tell you something, guys. take it from me. Most of these men that are anchors are, tell me, let me tell you something. They are crazy. They're wild, a lot of them. I'm not saying Nick is or anything like that, but I'm just saying I used to date a meteorologist, and he was in Virginia, and they are crazy. I'm just going to tell you that right now. They are. Kids have another week off school here. Oh, my God. That's crazy. He looks dorky. Well, I'm telling you, that's the ones you have to look out for. Oh, he's very intelligent. I mean, I think all of them are intelligent. I mean, I don't think you're getting a job there if you're, you know, dumber than a box of rocks. But I'm just saying a lot of them are wild. A lot of the men. Did you make it rain? You're funny. That's true, Chantel. That's true, too. That's true. Muscular guys never are. Muscular guys are like... They might be good on the eyes, but that's it until, you know, something else. That's all. I mean, you want to have someone with some, you know, too much to Yeah, I like Nick Bears. I do. I know he's kind of got a hard way to go lately because of that video, but he's not. That's a good way to say it. There you go, Melissa. Thank you. What Melissa said. Need more dating stories. Oh my God. Yeah. I like smart guys. I do. You want someone that's you can have a conversation with and thinks about things, right? Not someone that just My love life is tragic. Tragedy. What's that song? PG wants to do tell. Is PG in here? Or are you just saying PG wants to do tell? Yeah, intellectual conversations. I mean, you know, I like getting in a good conversation whenever, like, I'm driving or something, like a very deep conversation. And that way, like, it makes the time pass very, very quickly. All you're asking for, Peachy. Gotcha. Let's see if anything is going on here. Oh, what's this? Let's play this. Inside. Oh. And you'll always have a home. I guess I can play it because it's not going to. Wait, too, Grace.
The rain should find your heart.
I miss the 90s. Me too, Quinny. You can just reach for me and I'll be there. Don't lose hope. No. Never. I think she was yelling at him there. 4/2/24, show Sebastian you love him. You have hope and you will never give up on him. And finding, put his favorite color, green hearts. Oh, that's sweet. You know, I swear, the 90s were so good. I was watching this meme that's going on right now, and it says, it was like, what year were you born in? And this person says, like, I don't know, like 2002 or 2003 or something like that. And the other person's like, what year were you born in? And she's like, 1992. And she's like, you were born in the 1900s? And I'm thinking, oh shit. Yeah. Cause, you know, I mean, you're 24 years old if you were born, you know, in 2000, right? And it feels like 2000 was just not long ago. It was 24 freaking years ago. I'm like, ah. Like, that hurt my heart. What I mean, what's this? Do you know what kind of parking pass this is? I don't think it's Yogi Bear RV one. Oh, this must be. Oops, let's go to all comments. So it is a Yogi Bear. Okay. 1960. My youngest was born in 2000. Time flies. 1980. I know. And it's like, God, you know, I was born in the 80s and I'm starting to feel the aging process. Like, I can feel it in my body. And that's like, okay, that's new. You know what I mean? Like, I can never go back to the part of the video where Sebastian is in the car. Yeah, sure. I can do this. Like right there. I'm 67 and the aging process has a stranglehold. Well, I can feel the. Are you talking about this part right here? No, keep going. What did I do?
The rain should find your heart and you're cold and tired and
right here. Right here. Menopause was hell. I thankfully don't have that. Turn 60 this summer. Yes, see what? Where could the where could this big be? I'm so pissed. I don't know what you mean. What is on his chest there? Oh, that's his. He had to wear some type of brace of some sort. Hey, Jude, hold on. I need to make you a mod. Is there anyone else who mods for me that's not a mod? Speak now, forever hold your peace, at least for a while. Is Vet Girl still here? Vet Girl, are you around? Because it's ladies' night and I'm feeling right. Let's see here. Show her. Shows her. I don't see her. She's probably left. Or she's probably listening. Not working. I know, Judy. I hope he's found soon. I really do. Yeah, she wasn't here. She said she was working while she was listening, so. Anywho's. I'm at least two-thirds through my life, and I can't understand it because I feel like I haven't even started yet. It has come as a shock. Hazel, honest to God, like, I'm ready to hit 40, and I feel I'm like halfway through. I'm about halfway through, and I feel like, what? And that's if I live another 40 years. Right? Nothing's guaranteed. You know, if I've lived 40 years, billions of people before me, and many people now have not lived 40 years. So I'm incredibly lucky, but I'm like, what? Like, it doesn't. Thank you, seriously, Innocent. That's very sweet of you, but I have been feeling 40 lately. I'll be there in 2 weeks, and I don't even want to say it. Well, I just, you know, it goes by so quick. And I'm like, what if my next 40 years goes, like, because it feels like it speeds up. You know what I mean? Like, it really feels like life speeds up the older you get. And I'm like, well, what about, you know, if I live my next 40 years? Like, is it going to go quicker than the first 40? Because if it does, I'm like, it does. It takes forever. Maybe that's God's way of, you know, but it feels like it takes forever to become an adult, doesn't it? Feels like it takes forever. Yeah, just hang on for the ride. It's so short. It's so short. Life is so short. Oh, aging, the aging. I can't even talk about it. I'm 53 and loving life. Kids are grown, debt-free, and my husband and I do what we want and love it. That's wonderful. Proud of me. That's wonderful. There's some beautiful things about getting older. You know, you really give zero shits about something you would care when you was 20. Like zero. You know what I mean? It's like you've lived through that. You whatever. You know what I mean? Like you just don't care. I think you just learn, and I think it's your hormones too, probably. You just kind of, you're just like, eh, whatever. Whatever. That used to bother me. Now I'm like, all my nails. Trevor's live. Okay. All right. Let's go over to Trevor's. Let's go over to Trev Times, y'all. I want to support Trevor. He's my buddy, and I want to support him. He doesn't go live very often. Like I do, and like Josh does, so we go live all the time, but he doesn't go live very often, so I want to give Trevor some support. Trev Time, if mods would give a link to Trev Time, I would greatly appreciate it. That way people can just press that and it'll send them straight over there. My grandparents are 91 and 87 and have been married 71 years this May. God bless them, Miss Ryan. That is so amazing. That's so amazing. And I bet you they are just wonderful people. Love you too. Love you too. Thank you, Judy. All right. Hit that link. Max Chica just dropped it. Hit that and it'll send you right over to Trevor's. Love you guys. I might be back later. It just depends. It is amazing. Congratulations. Yeah. All right. SL dropped it. Hit that link and head on over. I'll see you over at Draft Times. Bye, guys.